Good morning.
Come on, with 2,000 people here, we have to rock the stadium. Good morning.
Good morning.
More like it. I am Dr. Nagi Naganathan, President of Oregon Tech, and it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this event. This is a special year in the history of Oregon Tech and for our graduates. This year, we are celebrating Oregon Tech's 75th anniversary, and class of 2023, you are graduating in this very special milestone year. Welcome to your commencement ceremony. At this time, I request you to stand if you are able and join me in opening our ceremonies with the national anthem. Please be seated. To our Oregon Tech graduating class, honored keynote speaker and State of Oregon Treasurer Tobias Reed, Board Chair John Davis, and other trustees, faculty, staff, families, and friends, welcome. We are so happy you are all here to join us for this important celebration in our newly renovated stadium named after John Moll, who was a member of Oregon Tech Original Booster Club and helped build the first stadium at this location with his colleagues and other community leaders. As we begin this ceremony, we recognize that Oregon Tech's Klamath Falls campus resides on the ancestral homelands and traditional territory of the Klamath, Modoc, and Yahuskin nations, who have stewarded this land since time immemorial. In doing so, we honor their legacy and lives, as well as commit to continuing to build a relationship with the native peoples of this region, the state of Oregon, and across the United States. I would also like to recognize and honor Oregon Tech students and graduates who are veterans and who are currently active in our military, as well as all of those in the audience today who have served in the armed forces. Thank you all for what you have done for all of us and all that you bring to our communities and the workplace. I am also pleased to greet Oregon Tech's alumni who are here with us today. Thank you for continuing to engage with and support Oregon Tech. You are not only a connection to our past, you are a foundational building block for the future success of our university and our graduates. With us today, I want to recognize this one alumnus who is with us. He's an esteemed alumna who is still very active in the Oregon Tech community and is a champion for our students and industry-driven partnerships. Please hold your applause as I request Diane Apple to rise now and stay standing for an introduction. Diane Apple is a member of the class of 1992 and is now chief manufacturing engineer for Boeing commercial airplanes. With her passion and commitment to Oregon Tech and our students, Diane has helped to create a very special partnership between Boeing and Oregon Tech, whereby Oregon Tech students can be employed as Boeing interns right in Klamath Falls while they are attending school and working on current Boeing projects under the guidance of Boeing engineers. This is a new model of internship in our industry's university paradigm that allows many more Oregon Tech students to get rich industry experience without navigating the typical constraints of having to relocate during their academic programs. So now, please join me in a round of applause to thank Diane Apple for her visionary leadership and commitment to Oregon Tech, making this partnership possible. Please be seated. Now, switching to our graduates, it gives all of us great pleasure to share this day with our graduates who have worked so diligently towards earning their degrees. Graduates, just 4 or 5 years ago, you set a goal to be seated where you are today. So, if you are rejoicing to have finally survived all those last-minute papers, all those topics, at least in some classes, that seem to be so far away from your interests, all the interactions and contemplations at the bookstore, all those computers, those darn computers that crashed just before you were going to back them up, and finally, to have survived all the 8 a.m. classes after being out at a coffee house all night. Parents, you do know that I'm being polite here. You have good reason to be rejoicing, and you should enjoy every moment of it. At the same time, let us also reflect for a few minutes on the past, present, and the future. Let me start with a famous quote on the future. The quote is, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. This 13-word quote is often attributed to famous First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt, although we have not been able to directly cite this to any of her works. But today, as I stand here before you, it is not the author of the quote that makes it meaningful. The value of these words is in their truth and the power you hold within yourselves as Oregon Tech graduates to shape the future you want for yourself, your loved ones, and the communities in which you live and support. Today, graduates, let the beauty of your dreams be the motivation that propels you into your next chapter, your own unique future. Often when we think of the future, we think of a far-off, indefinable time, which we can only know and understand after we reach a specific milestone. Too often, what we forget to recognize in our day-to-day lives is that yesterday's future is today and that tomorrow's future will be here soon enough. Throughout history, people have attempted to predict the future, whether for crop security and food resource availability, health outcomes for societies, or technology for advancement. The only certain thing we know about the future is that it will happen. And the most reliable way to predict the future is by having a hand in building it. This ceremony today is a future you began envisioning the day you applied to Oregon Tech. The cap, gown, and tassel you display today are recognition of a future you made happen. Regardless of your degree program, you believed in your ability to make positive and meaningful change in the world. You became an agent of change, first for yourself and then for others. Your accomplishment is a testament to your determination and resilience. Through uncertainty, isolation, adapting to new modes of learning through a multi-year pandemic, you drove yourself to stay focused in your studies and sought new ways to adapt and see the world. As graduates, that drive is what will make you successful as leaders of tomorrow. Whether you are entering the world as well-prepared professionals or continuing to an advanced program, it is time for you to demonstrate your value proposition to the world, to show the world what you are capable of. That means to build the future. With the Oregon Tech education you receive, the world you create is only limited by your own vision and determination. As you make your way to the world and make your way in the world, do not be complacent. As Oregon Tech graduates, you will be sought by local, national, and international employers, not just because of STEM-H jobs are in demand, but because of what you know and your ability to solve problems that are relevant to society. Step up and be leaders of tomorrow. Believe in yourself and your ability to be an agent of change. The future is not something that should just happen to us. When we exercise our power to be change makers, the future is something we build. I have every confidence that you will be successful in creating the future you envision. Today is only one of many opportunities you will have throughout your life to relish in an accomplishment as you look back on your path to success and as you keep raising the bar and setting stretch goals with a focus on excellence. The possibilities of your future will become realities when you can turn challenges into opportunities. When you can readily turn a negative into a positive, you will see that opportunity is all around you. In today's modern society, you are more connected than ever. The exchange of information occurs faster and more reliably than ever in human history. Embrace the tools and technology you have available to you, and as you pursue your passions, commit yourselves to making lives around the globe easier, healthier, and safer. By pursuing your dreams with passion, creativity, and determination, you can create a future aligned with your own values and aspirations. You have the skills to craft a better future for all. Go forward with a sense of purpose and service. Today, you have the distinction of graduating from Oregon's Polytechnic University. As the class of 2023, you also have the distinction of graduating as our university celebrates its 75th year of serving students. When you leave this stadium today, as newly minted Oregon Tech graduates, let the beauty of your dreams be the catalyst that inspire you to build the future. Explore new dimensions to be bold, dream big, don't forget that the future belongs to you. Now, graduates, I'm sure you will readily agree with me that your success today and the future possibilities did not happen just by your own efforts, but with the support of many special people in your lives, your parents, spouses, significant others, grandparents, in some cases, children. Without their love and support, this day would not be a reality. I would now like to pay tribute to all the parents and spouses of the graduates. May I request all of the parents and spouses and significant others of our graduates to please rise, and I ask everyone to join me in a round of applause. Don't be shy. I would now like to pay tribute to all the grandparents of our graduates. Would all the grandparents of our graduates please rise? May I now ask all the children and other beloved ones of our graduates to stand up and be recognized. Children and all others. Thank you. Thank you so much. It is now my pleasure to introduce our first speaker, John Davis, who currently serves as chair of the Oregon Tech Board of Trustees. Chair Davis has a proven track record of public service in Oregon and also with Oregon Tech and the communities in which he lives and supports. From 2013 to 2017, Chair Davis served as a member of the Oregon House of Representatives, representing District 26, which, as many of you know, is the Wilsonville area district where our Portland Metro campus is. He has also served as a member of the Oregon Tech Foundation Board and recently served as Vice President of the Foundation Board. Chair Davis has been a member of the university's Board of Trustees since March 2022 and was unanimously elected by fellow trustees to serve as board chair in August 2022. We are extremely grateful for Trustee Davis's dedication to our university. When he is not donating his time for the benefit of Oregon Tech's success, he is a business, nonprofit, and estate planning attorney practicing in Portland and Bend in Klamath Falls and serves as a managing partner in his law firm, Lynch Murphy McLean LLP. He earned his baccalaureate degree from George Fox University and his Juris Doctorate from Willamette University. His educational experience also includes a scholar semester tenure at Oxford in England. Chair Davis is one of Oregon Tech's most ardent champions and a strong supporter of collaboration both internally and externally. Since becoming board chair, he has demonstrated leadership in ensuring the Board of Trustees works in concert with our faculty, students, staff, and administration for continued success as Oregon's Polytechnic University. Thank you, Chair Davis, for all you have done and continue to do for Oregon Tech and for being here today to honor our distinguished graduates. Please join me now in welcoming Board Chair John Davis.
Thank you, Dr. Nagy, and thank everybody here for welcoming me today. While I've been involved with Oregon Tech for some time in the legislature and later as a part of the Oregon Tech Foundation, I look forward to my new involvement as board chair allows me. I want to say, first of all, on behalf of the graduates, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, thank you to a very special group who's with us today. And as I've learned over many years in higher education, the rock in any educational institution, which is the faculty. The faculty that have walked with each one of you graduates today through many years, who have mentored you, who you will walk away from here and still be able to call and email and rely on. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees and the graduates, please let's say a big thank you to our faculty for all they've done for you. I have a habit of mentoring a college student each year, and almost invariably they ask me, should I go to graduation? Which is always an odd question to me, because I'm kind of a guy who enjoys, you know, pomp and circumstance. And I always say, yes, absolutely you should come. And the reason to me is because the human condition requires that we have milestones in our life to look back on. I don't remember who spoke at my graduations, both from law school and undergraduate. Most of the professors here and graduates here probably don't remember, but I do remember that day. I remember sitting next to my friends. I remember my family in the crowd. So for graduates here today, when you're thinking, why am I here in the sun, getting hot and sweating in this black thing? You are here to imprint a memory in your heart, your mind, and your soul about the hard work that you have done over these last 4, 5, 6 years. And you're also here to honor your professors, the staff who's worked so hard to make sure you're successful, and your family and friends who are gathered here today. That's the reason you're here. You'll hear some speeches today. You'll get to see us dressed in funky outfits, but you're here to imprint a memory and to celebrate with those who love you, who care for you, and have walked with you for many, many years. So if you walk away from today, you made the right decision to be here. We are so thankful for your investment in Oregon Tech. And you will remember this day for the rest of your life as a milestone of when you accomplish something that very, very few people in our world get to accomplish. So well done, well done. So on behalf of the board, thank each of you graduates for your commitment to Oregon Tech. I look forward to continuing to serve as board chair and to starting a new academic year next year with optimism and a renewed focus. We're so excited about the next 75 years of our journey, and I'm so excited for each of you to get to hear from my friend in just a few minutes, our treasurer, Tobias Reed. And with that, I'll let Dr. Nagy introduce him. Thank you. Enjoy this day. And before I leave, as board chair, I get to have a prerogative and take a nice picture. So everybody, give me a little love there, huh? On that side, excellent. How about on this side? Give us a little bit. Oh, yes, you're beautiful. Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Chair Davis, for your special message and greetings to our graduates. It's now my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker, Oregon State Treasurer Tobias Reed. Treasurer Reed was elected to be Oregon's 29th State Treasurer in 2016, bringing a strong background in management, political, and finance policy experience to serve as Oregon's Treasurer. Treasurer Reed has a long history of serving the state of Oregon in many capacities and was elected, as I said before, as treasurer in 2016. He brings a strong background in management, political, and finance policy experience and strives to ensure Oregon's financial course stays on target. He's our state's chief investment officer. Prior to becoming treasurer, Tobias Reed worked in the U.S. Treasury and as a liaison between designers, engineers, and manufacturing units for Nike. In 2006, he was elected to the Oregon House of Representatives, where he served a decade and championed legislation to invest in public education, improve state financial management, finance critical infrastructure improvements, and help Oregonians save for a more secure future. Through his work, Treasurer Reed advocates for equity in higher education. Just a few years ago, he worked with a diverse group of organizations, including the Latina Network, Stand for Children, the Oregon Student Association, and state legislators to pass the Education Savings Credit, which makes it easier for low to moderate income families to save for education after high school through the Oregon College Savings Plan. The credit went into effect in 2020. He earned his bachelor's degree from Willamette University and his Master of Business Administration from the University of Washington. He lives in Beaverton with his wife, Heidi, and their two children. I have also had the pleasure to serve with Treasurer Reed in the Oregon Innovation Council, and his participation and his enthusiasm for entrepreneurship and innovation. Please join me in welcoming our keynote speaker, Oregon State Treasurer Tobias Reed.
Thank you, Dr. Naganathan, and thank you to all of you for attending. Thanks to Oregon Tech senior leadership, to department chairs, faculty and staff, to families, and especially to graduates. Congratulations. As state treasurer, I'm an investor, so I think about how to direct money, yes, but also time and effort. I also want to assure you, I'm a fan of efficiency, so I aim to be brief today. Hustling owls, you may not, that's the best attendance, the best applause line of the day, I suspect. Hustling owls, you may not think of yourselves as investors, but you are. You chose to come to school here, and I'm sure you agree that involved some expenditure of time and effort and perhaps money. So as we gather here today to celebrate you, I hope that you also believe, as I do, that your investment has paid off. Of course, I'm here to congratulate you on this significant achievement, but I'm also here to remind you that you are still investors with choices to make about how you will invest your time, your talents, and your passions as you move on from OIT. I first want to acknowledge, as I'm sure you recognize, that you didn't get here alone. And Dr. Naganathan already said this, but you probably didn't get here alone. And you probably won't get very far on your own either. Your families, given or chosen, your professors, your classmates, your community, all played a supporting role in bringing you here. So at the risk of being a little bit repetitive, Would you join me in looking around at all these people who have supported you, invested in you, and who love you, and give them acknowledgement one more time? Let's give them one more round of applause. Since you are investors, let's consider the way markets actually work. You will, of course, improve your chances of success, of doing something significant, if you use the advantages you have. You are graduates of Oregon's Polytechnic University with skills that very few people have. And I know that among you are many first-generation college graduates, future engineers, nurses, medical specialists, and business professionals. I had a professor in business school who said something that's really stuck with me. Ali Tarhouni was a Libyan immigrant who taught us microeconomics brilliantly. And he exhorted us constantly to satisfy the pain. I can't really bring the same feeling to that sentence that he did, but it sticks with me. And I think what he meant was that we have to look for real problems in the world to which we can offer solutions. The world has plenty of real problems these days, pressing problems, and we need all of you. That leads me to my next point, which is to encourage you to be bold. In 1962, President Kennedy was standing before a crowd, perhaps like this, at Rice University in Houston, and he told the world that we were going to the moon. Perhaps you've heard this sentence. He says, we choose to go to the moon in the next decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Lots of people know that sentence, but what follows was just about as important. He went on to say, because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Today, we need all of your energies and skills just as much as the country and the world needed those that the graduates of that era had. And for us right now, I'd suggest that the challenge of our time is the rapidly changing climate. But for all the existential challenge that the climate represents, it's also the opportunity of our time. I think we spend way too much time and effort arguing in our politics about how we got here, and way too little time building agreement on how to respond to the incontrovertible realities of a changing climate. They're evident all around us, from increased wildfires to droughts, to impacts on agriculture and many other things. We describe in excruciating detail all the things we want to avoid, and we should know about them, not just the physical effects of climate change, but the economic, the racial, the social repercussions. But at that same time, we don't do enough to talk about how much safer, more resilient, and more pleasant life can be when we take these challenges and the opportunities that they represent seriously. That's where you come in, you owls. We need your hustling nature to help us catch up, because again, part of being an investor is recognizing where you have advantages, where your skills, your talents, and your experiences match up with someone else's needs. What Ali Tarhouni would describe as the pain, and what I sincerely hope is a chance to change your future and the future of all of us that we will share together in ways that we can't even predict right now. Trust me, I'm not putting all of this responsibility solely on your shoulders. It's going to take all of us to meet these challenges. We've all got roles to play. We're going to especially be in need of scientists and entrepreneurs and business leaders. And I would put OIT on par with any other institution in the world to produce that talent and embrace those opportunities. But part of the reason I'm here today is to draw inspiration from all of you. I want to go home to my family and be able to tell my wife and kids about what I saw and heard here, and what I learned, what's given me hope, who I met, and assure all of them that part of what will build our shared future is coming from this university, from this community, and from all of you. But optimism without realism is just naive. So let's be realistic. We have to acknowledge that in politics and in life, we are confronted with real trade-offs. We can't have everything we want all at once without prioritizing. We can't achieve ambitious goals without sacrifices. And while no one can know the future for certain, it's a damn good bet that we will all experience bad results from time to time. Those results don't have to define us, but hopefully they will serve to inspire and teach us, to help us have a plan for whatever we're taking on. Because even with good preparation. Bad results can occur. It's the process that improves the odds of a good outcome, even though it can't guarantee it. I like what former Treasury Secretary Tim Geithner always says, plan beats no plan. So if I may be so bold, I'd like to suggest some pieces that should be part of your plan, not just for those of you who choose to take on climate change, but for all of you who will take on big challenges. And I think you all will, whether that's starting a career or a business, getting a graduate degree, starting a family, or any other of a million other experiences that will be in front of you or that you will create. Start with patience, and maybe end with it too, but not too much. It is a balancing act, after all. We all get these spam emails that promise get-rich-quick schemes, but we know that almost anything worth doing doesn't happen instantaneously, so be okay with incrementalism. In fact, if I could change one thing about how politics works in this country, it would be to add some tolerance for incrementalism. I feel so strongly that we would be better off if we could recognize that compromising on an issue is not compromising on your principles. It's simply recognizing what's possible today. So whether that's a scientific question, a policy debate, progress on a personal goal, or investing, the same is true. Do what you can today and keep working for improvements and hopefully growth over time. Finding that perfect balance of patience and urgency is probably not something you'll ever finish. So embrace it and keep at it. And be persistent. Be creative. That's the second thing. There's almost never just one way to come at something. If you don't get it right the first time, stick with it. Come at a problem from a different angle. Take a different route and be willing to ask for directions. Third, be willing to fail. Even better, learn from those failures. You've heard it before, but it's true. Coming up short has an enormous teaching power. I've always liked what the great economist and psychologist Daniel Kahneman said. He said, no one enjoys being wrong, but I've always enjoyed having been wrong because it means I am now less wrong than I was before. That's a lesson to hold on to. And I hear something from young people these days a lot that I felt when I was your age, an urge to have it all figured out right now. But I want to reassure you, you have time to figure things out. You have time to try things and to fail, and your future selves, your future efforts will be that much richer for the experience. Fourth, find your community. No person is an island. We all need each other for support and for challenge. Two quick stories that illustrate that for me. I was a rower in college, and the best thing about it was being part of a boat that forced me to go way beyond any place I could go on my own. If you could put yourself into a boat, trust me, 30 seconds into a race, every muscle in every body in that boat is screaming, stop. And somehow, the boat continues, propelled by the collective effort of that small community inside. I'm here to tell you, the same can be true in life off the water. When I was a legislator, I developed a really good relationship with a Republican colleague, in addition to then Representative Davis. I could go to him and say, listen, I know you're going to hate this idea, you're going to vote against it, but can you help me make it better? Can you help me find the flaws and make it stronger? It's a credit to him that he was always willing to do it, and it's just one of the reasons I like so much now Congressman Cliff Bentz. So find your community. One final thing. While all these ingredients are necessary, I don't think they are sufficient. There's something else that's needed. And it costs you nothing, even while it can make all the difference. Be kind. All of us need it, and we all appreciate it. So to make a sort of somewhat awkward connection back to the investment world, I think being kind is the unexpected bonus that can come as a surprise and motivate people to be more helpful. Give that boost to everyone you can. It pays off for the world and for you. If I step back from all of this, I'm reminded of why I got into this crazy business of public service. It's an irrational act, after all, to work hard on challenging issues for low pay and to expose oneself and one's family to public criticism. But I learned from my parents, as I'm sure many of you have learned, that I have an obligation because I was a beneficiary of people who came before me and invested in me. So I have an obligation to invest in people that will follow me. That's why I'm here, both in a figurative sense and a literal sense. I'm here as treasurer trying to make good on that debt, and I'm here in Klamath Falls because, like all of you, I'm an investor. I'm doing some due diligence with an eye to reinvesting. The issues we confront as a state, as a community, defy the kind of short-term, zero-sum approaches that seem to dominate our public discourse these days. They actually demand the kind of visionary, inclusive, and innovative solutions that you all specialize in. And what's even more encouraging is that these don't just apply to the day-in, day-out challenges that you will confront in your lives in the 21st century. I feel every confidence that they will create the ways we will make a successful climate transition. Now, one truly last thing. This is where I say in conclusion and you all applaud. No investor, no politician can ever leave a podium without making an ask. So here is my ask to all of you, you hustling owls. Please use your skills and your opportunities to serve your community. I'm told that 80% of you are from Oregon. That gives me some optimism. I want your community to be in Oregon. But even if it's not, dig in, sink some roots. Figure out ways that you can contribute. We need you. So thank you, and go Owls.
Treasurer Reed, thank you for those inspiring words. And the essence of the message is taking the role of an investor at any time. Don't look at it as only a recipient. So we do have, on behalf of the graduating class, a special token for you. Let me bring it up first. I did all of my exercise at the same time this morning. Wow. So we have a special token of our appreciation commemorating your presence and participation today. What is special about this gift? This beautiful owl was 3D printed by our students and represents the state-of-the-art education that Oregon Tech provides and what they receive at Oregon's Polytechnic University. In this historic milestone year, it also has a piece of history here. The wooden base is derived from recycled wood from the Learning Resource Center when it was damaged by the earthquake in 1993. So I want to thank many people, our students and others, who made it happen. So thank you so much for being with us today, and we look forward to a continued great partnership. Thank you, Chair Davis. That's very kind. Before moving on, as I mentioned before, the gift was created by our students and faculty. I would also like to recognize three individuals who created that impressive owl that was just given to Treasurer Reed as a token of appreciation. I extend special thanks to student Aiden Williamson, one of our graduates today. He is in the audience. Facilities Maintenance Supervisor Jim Lake, and Manufacturing and Mechanical Engineering Technology Department Chair Tim Pasong for crafting this fine owl for our guest speaker. Now, as we begin the recognition portion of our ceremony, I would like to begin with special thanks to members of our faculty and staff. The awards given today are recognition of the dedication, passion, and talent our faculty and staff bring to our university. It is only through their work every day that our university's mission continues to be met for the betterment of our students' experience and success. At this time, may I request all of our faculty to stand up and be recognized. All of the faculty members, please. Thank you for your presence and participation. I would now like to recognize all of our staff and administrators, including those on the platform, to please rise so we can recognize you for your contributions. Staff and administrators. Thank you. Please be seated. Next, I'm pleased to recognize a very special group of attendees today. We are, as I said earlier, we are grateful to our network of alumni and know that there are many here with us today. I would like to take the opportunity to recognize a special group, our Golden Owls, who have joined us to celebrate this class. Members of the Golden Owls are alumni who graduated from Oregon Tech more than 40 years ago. Traditionally, one or more of the Golden Owls leads the student graduation procession. Today, joining us in the procession are 15 members of that illustrious group, and over 50 alumni and guests joined us for the annual Golden Owls reunion. Will the Golden Owls that took part in today's procession and all other Golden Owls in attendance today please rise if you are able, or raise your hand so we can recognize you with a round of applause. Please be seated. Having you back here is so special for all of us. It's a delight to have you back with us on campus in person. I hope your visit has been as special for you as your presence has been for us. Thank you for your continued engagement and support in so many ways. I would now like to present the Oregon Tech Foundation of Foundation Excellence in Teaching Award. This student-selected award honors faculty members who have made a difference in the lives of students through outstanding teaching performance, exemplary commitment to students, and leadership initiatives supporting student success. This year's recipient from the College of Engineering, Technology, and Management is Christy Weidman, instructor in the Department of Management from the Klamath Falls campus. Christy, would you please stand and be recognized? And this year's recipient from the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences is David Johnston, instructor in the Department of Natural Sciences from the Portland Metro campus. We will get to thank him in person tomorrow. Please join me in congratulating again this exemplary faculty. This year we have four faculty members and two administrators who are selected to receive the prestigious title Emeritus upon their retirement. If they are present, I request them to stand when I recognize them by name. Please hold your applause until I mention all six names. The 2023 Emeritus faculty are Lloyd Parrott, Assistant Professor who has served at Oregon Tech since 2009. Dr. Maureen Savigny, Professor who has served at Oregon Tech since 1995. Dr. Michael Spector, Professor and Executive Director for Industry Partnerships, who served Oregon Tech from 85 to 2007. And Dr. Sherry Yang, Professor, who has served at Oregon Tech since 1997. The 2023 Emeritus Administrators are Dr. Erin Foley, Vice President of Student Affairs and Dean of Students, who has served at Oregon Tech since 99, and Kelly Caleb, Head Athletic Trainer, who has served at Oregon Tech since 2007. Please join me in congratulating our Emeritus faculty and administrators. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Erin Foley, Vice President for Student Affairs and Dean of Students, who will recognize our student awardees who have recorded special accomplishments during their education at Oregon Tech. Vice President Foley has led our Student Affairs Division for 24 years, mentoring and supporting students to ensure their success. This ceremony will be Vice President Foley's last commencement in an official capacity as she is retiring this year. Vice President Foley has been a steadfast supporter of Oregon Tech students and throughout the years participated in as many athletic events, school activities, and club events as humanly possible. Vice President Foley's many responsibilities at Oregon Tech have included student life, housing, the health center, retention, public safety, admissions, and athletics. Her attention has always been on our students and their success, now and after they leave Oregon Tech as well. Thank you, Vice President Foley, for all you have done for Oregon Tech. Please join me now in welcoming Vice President Erin Foley to recognize the Student Awards of Excellence.
Thank you, President Naganathan, for that introduction. This has always been my favorite time of year, when I get to help celebrate the achievements of Oregon Tech's graduates. It's also a bittersweet time because I'm saying goodbye to another class of students. Sorry, Chris. So I, along with many others, will always remember this class and the incredible challenges brought on by the pandemic. Thank you for being part of everything that makes Oregon Tech a very special place, and congratulations. All right, now on to the presentation of student awards. Starting with the university-wide awards for students from any campus location, please stand to be recognized. The Hiram M. Hunt Award recipient is Laura Ashley Townsell, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Healthcare Management, Clinical Management. The most dedicated student award this year goes to Colby Mahoney, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Biology Health Sciences. The Oregon Tech Pride Award recipient is Nicholas McMillan, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Biology and Health Sciences. You guys can stay standing. The Student Achievement Award goes to Courtney Isom, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Operations Management. And this year's Graduate Student Achievement Award goes to Carter Wilson, graduating with a Bachelor and Master's of Science in Civil Engineering. The Outstanding Community Service Award goes to the Land Party. That includes Anestia Adul, Applied Mathematics, Levi Halleck, and Noah as a priority, both mechanical engineering. The Outstanding Non-Traditional Student Award goes to Arthur Spears, a graduate with a Bachelor of Science in Software Engineering Technology at our Portland Metro campus. The Outstanding Student Veteran Award goes to Clinton Lytle, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Renewable Energy Engineering. And the Owen Citizenship Award this year honors Monte Shell, Bachelor of Science in Biology and Health Sciences. Please give these award recipients a rousing round of applause. You may sit down. Congratulations, recipients. The outstanding scholars are students appointed by their department chair or program director who, in the opinion of the faculty, have demonstrated academic excellence in their major. Only one student may be appointed for any given program. Outstanding scholars are identified by a distinctive blue and gold cord worn today at commencement and have received a certificate recognizing their academic excellence. Will the 2023 Outstanding Scholars please rise? Now you guys can honor them a little bit more than that. Come on now. Congratulations. Thank you. Congratulations. You may sit down. From those Outstanding Scholars, the President's Senior Cup recipients are chosen. Recipients of the 2023 President's Senior Cup are Rajvi Patel from the College of Engineering, Technology, and Management. and Ashley Ripplinger from the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences. Congratulations and best wishes to all of our student awardees, and congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Vice President Foley. Congratulations to all the awardees Vice President Foley just recognized. For our first student speaker today, we'll have the pleasure of hearing from a graduating student who represents both the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences and the College of Engineering, Technology, and Management. I am pleased and proud to now introduce Ashley Ripplinger, who is graduating today with a double major in Civil Engineering and Environmental Sciences. Ashley, please come and join me here. Stand with me. Ashley is graduating from Oregon Tech. Such a slacker, only a 4.0 GPA, and was chosen as the outstanding scholar for both civil engineering and environmental sciences, winner of the Health Arts and Sciences President Senior Cup Award, and was nominated for the Student Achievement Award. Ashley played collegiate volleyball for Oregon Tech and was named to the Cascade Collegiate Conference All-Academic Team, the College Sports Communicators National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics Academic All-District 14, and was a National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics Scholar Athlete for the 2022 season. In addition to her academic and athletic achievements, Ashley was active and accomplished in student life as well. She was involved in Oregon Tech Clubs as Digital Media Officer of the American Society of Civil Engineers, and Vice President of the Institute of Transportation Engineers. She is also a member of the Engineering Honor Society, Tau Beta Pi. Ashley recently already passed the Fundamentals of Engineering exam, which is the first of two examinations that engineers must pass to be licensed as a professional engineer in the United States. Upon graduation, Ashley will work for civil engineering consulting firm McKay Sposito. Please join me in welcoming student speaker, Ashley Ripplinger.
Okay, hello everybody. Thank you for joining us to celebrate all the graduates here today. We're all very excited to no longer be poor college kids anymore. Now we just won't be college kids. But all jokes aside, I don't think Dr. Foley asked me to speak at graduation so I can practice my stand-up routine. Instead, I'm gonna practice my acceptance speech in case I win an Academy Award or something like that. So please don't play music to shoo me off stage if I take too long. So first, I'd like to thank my parents for always being in my corner. I wouldn't be here today without their unconditional love and support. My mom is the reason I'm up here today speaking to all of you. When I told her about this opportunity, she cried. So I really couldn't let her down. She said that us graduates have an opportunity to fix all the things that her generation messed up. So good luck with that task of a lifetime, everybody. So I'd also like to thank my brother for never failing to make me laugh. You're the best sibling I could have asked for. And don't worry, I know I'm the one up here with a fancy cap and gown and a microphone, but mom and dad still love you too. Thank you to my boyfriend who's taken me on so many adventures and has been a shoulder to cry on so many times. Without you, I would have just had to cry by myself, and where's the fun in that? To my fellow graduates, I hope you can find the time to thank the people in your life who have helped you through this experience here at Oregon Tech. Now's a great time to express your gratitude, as we have quite a bit today. I'd also like to thank all the friends I've made along the way. This experience would never be the same without you. To some of you, I hope to stay in touch for years to come. For others, I might see you in a supermarket somewhere and we'll both decide whether or not to say hi to each other. On a more serious note, I hope we can all take the time today to give thanks to the people in our lives who have passed away. I know I have lost some loved ones along the way, as I'm sure many of you have. Although they may be gone physically, they've had a lasting impact on us, and we can only hope to cultivate and hold that with us as we continue the rest of our lives. For the last of my thank yous, I want to thank the faculty at Oregon Tech. The professors we interact with here every day are what add value to this education. It's the office hours, it's the day-to-day interactions, the random conversations about random topics that make this education beneficial and well-rounded. I will cherish the relationships I've made with the faculty here, and I know many of you share the same sentiment. Although some gratitude can't raise their pay or solve their problems, it can't hurt. So can everyone join me in another round of applause for our wonderful faculty at Oregon Tech. All right, to wrap up this speech before the music starts to play me off, I want to leave my fellow graduates with this. There's more to life than your career. There's more to life than technology or profits or your salary. I know we're all leaving with degrees from a technical university, but I hope you also leave here with a desire for more than just monetary success. My former Spanish teacher told her students to work to live, don't live to work. I hope you find the time to enjoy your time. I hope you find kindness, community, fulfillment, enrichment, gratitude, and joy. There is so much joy out there, even if it's hidden behind the world's unkindnesses. I hope everyone here today can find that joy. So thank you, and congratulations to my fellow graduates.
Thank you, Ashley, for those remarks to your student colleagues and to the families and friends and all of us here today. I am now pleased to welcome Trent Lamont, our student speaker from the College of Engineering, Technology, and Management. Trent, would you come and join me here, please? Trent is graduating from our mechanical engineering program, magna cum laude, and from the Oregon Tech Honors Program. Trent is a recipient of the D'Arman Manufacturing Fellow Scholarship, which provides an educational experience through Oregon Tech and the Oregon Manufacturing Innovation Center Research and Development, and it includes an internship at the Research and Development Facility in Scappoose to work collaboratively with researchers and industry professionals. While at the facility, Trent participated in hands-on applied professional development experience and mentoring incoming fellows. Here on campus, Trent was involved in housing and residence life for 3 years. He served his fellow students by working as a resident assistant, senior resident assistant, and senior head resident. He also worked at the Oregon Tech radio station, KTAC, as programming director and station manager, and helped bring back the Oregon Tech Music Garden event in 2023 after a peak pandemic years. Trent also donated his time to the university administration by volunteering on the university's financial allocation committee from 2022-23 and was a member of the new student housing project steering committee. Today, Trent graduates as a member of the Engineering Honors Society Tau Beta Pi. He has already secured a job at Oregon Manufacturing Innovation Center, R&D, and has certainly made a lasting mark at Oregon Tech. You know, on a personal note, I remember calling Trent even before he came into Oregon Tech physically as a student, and it's wonderful to see him do so well and to be able to share the stage with him today. Please join me in welcoming Trent Lamont.
The tone of my speech is slightly different from the last one, but I think that's more fun this way. Today, as we stand here on the precipice of a new chapter in our lives, I am reminded of the profound significance of change. Change, though often challenging to navigate, is an inevitable part of our journey. Now we are about to begin some of the greatest changes in our lives as we leave this campus and move on towards the next phase in our lives. But amidst this constant flux lies the beauty of our experience. The ability to adapt and process new information, to learn not just what we know, but how to apply it. And now, as we prepare to leave the familiar confines of the classroom, we have the opportunity to apply our knowledge in shaping a better future. I know that the prospect of venturing into the unknown can be intimidating, but the responsibility of contributing to the world and building a better tomorrow rests squarely on our shoulders. However, I see before me a group of individuals who possess the strength and capability to overcome that fear and succeed as graduates. We must approach our future endeavors with humility and a willingness to admit when we don't know something, embracing the process of acquiring knowledge with grace and patience, and we need to continue to exercise perseverance and resiliency, which we needed to get here today. Our professors have equipped us with the necessary skills to thrive, and now it is up to us to take the risks required to find our own success. The hands-on experiences we have gained, whether it be creating asphalt mixes, scanning hearts, machining parts, or programming microcontrollers, go beyond what a mere book can teach us. These experiences are uniquely ours, forever ingrained in our being, and they will continue to shape us as we navigate various paths in life. Today, I stand here filled with gratitude for each and every one of you, my classmates who have journeyed alongside me. Without our shared experiences, support, and camaraderie, I am unsure if I would have made it to this moment. Together, we have overcome challenges, celebrated successes, and formed bonds that will endure beyond this campus. I also extend my heartfelt thanks to the faculty members who have guided us during our time at Oregon Tech. Their dedication to our growth and their ability to see us as individuals, understanding the complexities of our lives, have played a pivotal role in our achievements. We owe them a debt of gratitude for their unwavering support. As we leave this institution and embark on our individual journeys into the unknown, let us remember not to give away everything we have learned. Our knowledge and experiences make us unique and valuable. While we should mentor and guide others, we should never make ourselves replaceable. Today, I'm honored to stand among you, my classmates, as we celebrate our collective achievements. We have overcome numerous obstacles and now are prepared to embrace the future with optimism, resiliency, and a commitment to learning. Together, let us embark on this next phase of our lives, ready to make a difference and shape the world in our own unique ways. Congratulations to us, the class of 2023.
Okay. Thank you, Ashley and Trent. Please know your stories are bound to inspire others, and your active involvement at Oregon Tech during your time here has made a difference. It's now my pleasure to welcome Oregon Tech's Vice Provost for Research and Academic Affairs and Interim Dean, College of Engineering, Technology and Management, Dr. FJ, to the podium for the presentation of our graduates. Vice Provost Abdi FJ joined Oregon Tech in 2018. Before joining Oregon Tech, he was the Distinguished University Professor at the University of Toledo in Ohio. Dr. FJ served as the Director of Major Research Initiatives, Chair of the Department of Mechanical, Industrial, and Manufacturing Engineering, and as founding director of the Small Turbine Engine Institute in partnership with Teledyne CAE. He was also elected nationally to the prestigious rank of the Fellow of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers and was resident faculty at the NASA John H. Glenn Research Center at Lewis Field and the Ohio Aerospace Institute. Vice Provost FJ is known for his focus on student success and has led comprehensive efforts focused on student achievement, fostering enrollment growth, and improving department visibility. Dean FJ also developed a joint international graduate degree program in India in mechanical and industrial engineering. Please join me in welcoming Vice Provost and Dean Dr. Abdi FJ.
President Naganathan. Will the graduates of the Oregon Institute of Technology's College of Health, Arts, and Sciences and OHSU's School of Nursing please rise? Will the faculty please rise? President Naganathan, these students who comprise the class of 2023 are candidates for bachelor's and master's degrees in their respective fields. Upon completion of their required curriculum, they are recommended by the faculty to receive their degrees.
Thank you, Dr. FJ. Upon the recommendation of the faculty, and by the authority vested in me by the State of Oregon and the trustees of the Oregon Institute of Technology, I do confer upon all of the qualified candidates, including those in absentia, the bachelor's and master's degrees in the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences and the OHSU School of Nursing, for which they have met the requirements. You are charged with the duties and responsibilities of the degree and granted the privileges and prerogatives appertaining thereto. Congratulations, class of 2023. Please join me in a round of hands for our new graduates. And now we will begin the recognition ceremony for our graduates of the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences and the OHSU School of Nursing. Dr. Dan Peterson, Dean of the College of Health, Arts, and Sciences, along with Dr. Franny House and Professor Carmen Morgan, will now recognize each of the graduates. Dean Peterson, please be seated meanwhile.
Thank you, President Naganathan, and congratulations, graduates. College of Health, Arts, and Sciences graduates will enter the platform from my left and move across the stage. After the department presenter reads your name, the graduate will accept their degree recognition from President Naganathan, pause for a moment for a brief photo, and leave the stage to my right. We will begin with the Department of Communication graduates presented by Assistant Professor, or actually by Professor Matt Schnackenberg.
The first degree in the School of Health Arts and Sciences is Bachelor of Science Communication Studies. Sarah Handyside, summa cum laude, lambda pi eta, outstanding scholar.
Presenting the graduates of the Department of Dental Hygiene is Department Chair Professor Paula Russell.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Dental Hygiene, led by outstanding scholar Jennifer Webb, magna cum laude. Muhammad Al-Duriz, magna cum laude.
Jensen Becker, cum laude, NAIA scholar athlete.
Katie Contreras.
Soraya Cox, cum laude.
Taylor Grace Daniel.
Madeline DeVerna.
Lauren Vo, cum laude. Gabrielle Kapualani Tomas, magna cum laude.
Abigail Jane Thompson.
Chelsea Lynn Thomas, cum laude.
Naomi Shoji, magna cum laude.
Kayla Mick, summa cum laude, academic NAIA All-American, NAIA scholar-athlete.
Vin Lay, summa cum laude.
Hannah Mason, cum laude, NAIA scholar-athlete.
Robin Danae Lathrop, summa cum laude.
Cade Evan Hutchins, magna cum laude.
Callie Lauren Drescher, magna cum laude.
Presenting the graduates for the Department of Humanities and Social Sciences is Department Chair Professor Maria Lynn Kessler.
The next degree is Master of Science, Applied Behavior Analysis. Sarah Welsh. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Applied Psychology, led by outstanding scholar Irene Aguirre, summa cum laude.
Hannah Aguirre Burke.
Eduardo Barraza Osoria.
Kenzie Lynn Cooper, magna cum laude.
Faith Hull, cum laude.
Tommy Min Lay.
Jennifer Leon Cobian. Sadie Ann Kaliko Mohala Lehua Ikihena Mieko Luis.
Nice. Anna Malone.
I like the air horn. Well done.
Garrett Martin.
Congratulations.
Isabel Ocampo Solano.
Stephanie Rizzo.
Selena Jane Rubio Montez.
Ellie Grace Smith.
Mia Sky Smith, summa cum laude.
Marissa Valencia. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Population Health Management. Melody Heights.
Alejandra Elena Mendez.
Madam Vice President, congratulations.
Keshia Norman.
Krista Ward.
The next degree is Master of Science, Allied Health Administration, Zachary Stockton.
Congratulations.
The next degree is Master of Science, Allied Health, Dental, Rachel M. Gaisley.
Stacy Neely.
Kimberly Pratt. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Respiratory Care. Erica Brooks, magna cum laude, NAIA All-American.
Samantha Harris, cum laude.
Demi Ann Hayes.
Jennifer Marie Leggett, magna cum laude.
Alex Malcolm, cum laude.
Jasmine Marin.
Kiana Kalena Kimie Nagasako.
Peyton Plurd, cum laude.
Michaela Retzela, magna cum laude.
Madeline Smith.
Michael Tarakshian.
Cameron Taylor.
Madison Ray Toll, magna cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Bentley Watson.
Presenting the graduates for the Department of Medical Imaging is Department Chair, Associate Professor Rich Carson.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Diagnostic Medical Sonography, led by outstanding scholar Annie Teja, summa cum laude.
Hope Adamson, cum laude.
Lacey May Augustus, cum laude.
Veronica Brown, magna cum laude.
Lisa Michelle Castro, magna cum laude.
Lauren Edwards, summa cum laude, lambda nu.
Taylor Christine Grew, magna cum laude.
Genesis Hazelhofer, magna cum laude.
Sydney Headland, magna cum laude, lambda nu.
Haley Sue Heldstab, cum laude.
Hope Nakata, cum laude. Hallie Noga, cum laude, lambda nu.
Megan Olson, cum laude, lambda nu.
Logan Tito, cum laude.
Avery Richter, cum laude, lambda nu.
Michelle Sekafetz, cum laude, lambda nu. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Echocardiography, led by outstanding scholar Twing Tran, summa cum laude, lambda nu.
Eveline Roxana Alexander.
Macy Paul Althoffer, cum laude.
Joel Beard.
Kelly Burraway, cum laude.
Kyra Cambra, cum laude.
Bailey Carter.
Aaliyah Cates.
Ellen Hilliker, cum laude.
Molly Jones.
Keegan Lozinski, cum laude, lambda nu.
Madeline Noelle Oakden.
Hannah Peterson, cum laude.
Vinnie Sanchez.
Madison Sweeney.
Eliana Ray Thompson, cum laude.
Riley Vaughn.
Andrea Lynn Welch.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Nuclear Medicine and Molecular Imaging Technology, led by outstanding scholar Lily Levine, summa cum laude.
Osaya Avendano Gomez, cum laude.
Megan De Almeida.
Jordan Drog.
Caitlin Edick, cum laude.
Nicholas Arnold Fuchs, magna cum laude.
Sahaley Rose Levine, cum laude, lambda nu.
Abigail McDevitt.
Kiara Mitchell.
Madeline Ross, summa cum laude.
Allison Thompson, cum laude, lambda nu.
Katie Contreras Wills.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Science, led by outstanding scholar Emily Stevens, summa cum laude, lambda nu.
Cade Edwin Beer, summa cum laude.
Kayleen Coker, summa cum laude.
Caitlin Christ, magna cum laude, lambda nu.
Richard Cullen, cum laude, lambda nu.
Laura Raquel Curiel, cum laude, lambda nu.
Kelsey Leanne Day, cum laude, lambda nu.
Michaela Del Valle.
Haley Eagles.
Joshua Farner, cum laude.
Reagan Nicole Gale, magna cum laude, lambda nu.
Sarah May Gerke, lambda nu.
Kelsey Gould, cum laude, lambda nu. Jose Ruben Gutierrez Garcia, cum laude, lambda nu.
Natalie Hafner, summa cum laude.
Cammy Harris.
Orville Hayward, cum laude.
Brianna Ladish, cum laude.
Trevor Ladish, summa cum laude.
Kaylin Howard Kirtley, lambda nu.
Kaiser Howerton, cum laude, lambda nu.
Naya Kendall, cum laude, lambda nu.
Steve Cleespies, cum laude.
Sophia Lardy.
Reed Michael Madsen, summa cum laude.
Lindsay McCutcheon, cum laude.
Cheyenne Mae McKenzie, cum laude, lambda nu.
Bailey Rose Moore, summa cum laude, lambda nu.
Esmeralda Ortiz, cum laude, lambda nu.
Laurel Peril.
Maya Phelps, magna cum laude.
Aaliyah Paulus, summa cum laude.
Ashley Nicole Ripplinger, magna cum laude, lambda nu.
Lana Skeen, summa cum laude, lambda nu.
John Torgerson, cum laude, lambda nu.
Leilani Lanai Feaina Vasquez, lambda nu.
Jake Weinhart, cum laude. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Vascular Technology, led by outstanding scholar Nathan Horton, cum laude, lambda nu.
Kayla Hamilton.
Kelsey Kuhnhausen, cum laude, lambda nu.
Carissa Pixley, cum laude, lambda nu.
Andrea Santillan.
Anna Thord.
Presenting the graduates for the Department of Natural Sciences is Department Chair, Associate Professor, Dr. Nate Bickford.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Biology, Health Sciences, led by outstanding scholar Michael Gray, summa cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Courtney Bennett.
Maggie Box.
Alex Burkhartsmeyer, summa cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta, NAIA All-American.
Cameron Caldwell, summa cum laude.
Riley Combs.
Alex Conley, NAIA All-American.
Cullen David.
Anna Edwards.
Patrick Hirado, magna cum laude.
Daniel Hartzell, cum laude.
Eileen Herring, Alpha Epsilon Delta, summa cum laude.
Jesse Higgins, summa cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Georgie Hill.
Colby Michael Mahoney, summa cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta, Most Dedicated Student Award.
Nicholas McMillan, magna cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta, NAIA Scholar Athlete, Oregon Tech Pride Award, NAIA All-American.
Amber Miller, magna cum laude.
Angel Mondragon, Alpha Epsilon Delta.
Paris Newdahl.
Mackenzie Peterson, summa cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Asia Phelps, cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta.
Teddy Faith Pitt.
Muir Selvig, cum laude.
Claire Wilson, cum laude, Alpha Epsilon Delta.
Jared Wilson. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Environmental Sciences, Gabby Herring.
Brody Maloney.
Quinn McDowell.
Maddie Smith, magna cum laude.
Haley Woodward.
Graduates of the OHSU School of Nursing will now be recognized by Associate Professor Dr. Tamara Rose.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, OHSU Nursing, Samantha Deanna Adams.
Jessa Donaldson.
Alexa Fanning.
Santos Maricela Flores Pena.
Dalton Gray.
Jane Heng, magna cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Grace Hull, magna cum laude, sigma theta tau, NAIA scholar athlete.
Cassidy Lesson, magna cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Nicholas Lynch, NAIA scholar athlete.
Michaela McKelvey, summa cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Mary Catherine Mincher, cum laude.
Carla Morales, magna cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Jessica Pettigrew, summa cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Fatima Pinedo Boteo, cum laude.
Cheyenne Reichert, magna cum laude, sigma theta tau.
Josiah Rourke.
I think he goes straight.
Will the graduates of the Oregon for the Oregon Institute of Technology's College of Engineering, Technology and Management, please rise. Will the faculty please rise? President Naganathan, these students who comprise the class of 2023 are candidates for associate, bachelor's, and master's degrees in their respective fields. Upon completion of the required curriculum, they are recommended by the faculty to receive their degrees.
Thank you, Dr. F.J. Upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority vested in me by the State of Oregon, and the trustees of the Oregon Institute of Technology, I do confer upon all of the qualified candidates, including those in absentia, the associate, the bachelor's and master's degrees in the College of Engineering, Technology and Management for which they have met the requirements. You are charged with the duties and responsibilities of the degree and granted the privileges and prerogatives appertaining thereto. Congratulations. Please join me in congratulating our ETM graduates with a round of applause. And now we will begin the recognition ceremony for our graduates. Please be seated. And now we will begin the recognition ceremony for our graduates for the College of Engineering, Technology and Management. Dean F.J., along with Dr. Franny House and Carmen Morgan, will now recognize each of the graduates.
Thank you, President Naganathan, and congratulations, graduates. College of Engineering, Technology and Management graduates, please enter the platform from my right and move across the stage when your name is read. Accept your degree from President Naganathan, pause for a moment for a photograph, and leave the stage to my left. Presenting the graduates of the Department of Civil Engineering is Department Chair Professor Roger Lindgren.
The first degree in the School of Engineering, Technology, and Management is Master of Science, Civil Engineering. Caroline Elizabeth Herkamp, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering, and a Bachelor of Science, Environmental Sciences, summa cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
That'd be too small, but it'll start.
Caroline Schultz, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering.
Keanu Srivangsana, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering.
Bailey May Werner, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering, summa cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Carter Wilson, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering, Graduate Student Achievement Award.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering, led by outstanding scholar Ashley Marie Ripplinger. Also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Environmental Sciences, summa cum laude, President Senior Cup, Tau Beta Pi.
Peter Hayden.
Jacob Kenneth Keller.
Mitchell Douglas Leach.
Skylar Bryce Lysakowski.
Bill Timmons.
Leif Toole.
Zachary Walker.
Presenting the graduates for the Department of Computer Systems Engineering Technology is Interim Department Chair, Associate Professor Dr. Phil Howard. Before we recognize the next group of graduates, we would like to present a posthumous diploma for Casey Bradley in Software Engineering Technology to her mother and father, Tammy and Rob Bradley.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Embedded Systems Engineering Technology. Ruby Kelly.
Woo! Colton Rhodes.
Andrew Snowden.
Mason Witchman.
The next degree is Associate of Engineering, Software Engineering Technology, Andrew Malenix.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Software Engineering Technology, led by outstanding scholar Drew Bryant, summa cum laude.
Jason Adam.
Brett Bertrand.
Victor Bonnet.
Destin Dahlgren.
Joshua Davies.
Caitlin Dickinson, cum laude.
Eli Jones, summa cum laude.
JC Leonard, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Embedded Systems Engineering Technology.
Reeb Tyler Lucas.
Tucker Nolte.
Jacob Presley, cum laude. Honors Program.
Brandon Toledo.
Jacob Vandercar, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Embedded Systems Engineering Technology, magna cum laude.
Joe Wilkinson, cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Devin Wolford.
Graham Shively, summa cum laude.
Presenting the graduates of the Department of Electrical Engineering and Renewable Energy Engineering is Department Chair, Professor Scott Prawl.
The next degree is Master of Science, Renewable Energy Engineering. Tony Augustine, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Renewable Energy Engineering.
William Stobaugh.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Electrical Engineering, led by outstanding scholar Benjamin Adams, cum laude.
Cameron Behrman, cum laude.
Darren Chitwood, magna cum laude.
Benjamin Driggers.
Jaden Hall, cum laude.
Alex Hovden.
Andrew Huang, magna cum laude, tau beta pi.
Aaron Sprouse, cum laude.
Vitaly Tverdin.
Matthew Warren.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Renewable Energy Engineering, led by outstanding scholar Mohsin Mohammed Al-Mofarji, summa cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Stephen Barton, cum laude.
Jacob Cometto.
Kyle David Gallegos.
Dylan Grogan, magna cum laude.
Ryan Kyle, magna cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Josiah Rye.
Rayan Saga, summa cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Alessandro Vittorio Zago, magna cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Presenting the graduates of the Department of Geomatics is Department Chair Professor Jack Walker.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Geomatics, Geographic Information Systems option. Jamie Blankenship.
Kayla Franklin, magna cum laude.
McKenna Hine, cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Geomatics, Surveying option, Matthew Bradshaw.
Max Jewell.
Tyler Ryan Kropp, summa cum laude.
Ethan Michael Moritz, cum laude.
Peter Sherwood.
Matthew Jamison Smith.
Brendan Talonen.
Presenting the graduates of the Department of Management is Department Chair Professor Hallie Newbert.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Accounting, Rajvi Patel, summa cum laude, Honors Program, Outstanding Scholar, President Senior Cup.
Liliana Tapia, cum laude, Outstanding Scholar.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Business, Management option, Carlos Daniel Garcia.
Jared Odell.
Neil Patel.
Go, Neil.
Gavin Wilmot, cum laude, outstanding scholar.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science Business, Marketing option, led by outstanding scholar Ethan Rowe, magna cum laude.
Come on, boy.
Bradley Charles Everest, Business Ambassador.
Taylor Hampton.
Kiernan Mateo. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Cybersecurity, led by outstanding scholar Clarice Tapkin, summa cum laude.
Travis Jones.
Congratulations.
Jackson McCray.
Alexander Reese, cum laude.
Brooke Adlin Yancey. The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Healthcare Management Administration Option, led by outstanding scholar Alicia Marie Volk, summa cum laude, NAIA scholar athlete.
Kristen Farrell, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Applied Psychology, cum laude.
Kaylee Jimenez.
Catherine Nielsen.
Mackenzie Morgan.
Cherise Reich.
Sylvia Rose Sloss, cum laude, NAIA scholar athlete.
Kaylin Talanen, magna cum laude, NAIA scholar athlete.
Karina Villegas, cum laude.
Dylan Michael Yoshinaga, summa cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Healthcare Management, Clinical Management Option, led by outstanding scholar Laura Townsell, magna cum laude, Hiram M. Hunt Award.
Landry Blow, summa cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Information Technology, led by outstanding scholar Gerardo Nunez Dominguez, summa cum laude.
Kyle Baker.
Danielle Howard, summa cum laude.
Dylan Miguel, magna cum laude.
Connor Wyatt Smith, summa cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science Operations Management, led by outstanding scholar Courtney Isom. Summa cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete, Student Achievement Award.
Brad Johnston.
Cody Stephen Kimball, summa cum laude, business ambassador.
Matthew Macias.
Kyle Wright, magna cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Applied Science, Technology and Management, led by outstanding scholar Taylor Renee Haugen, summa cum laude.
Alex Alexander.
Justin Krieger, cum laude.
Robert Stewart.
Presenting the graduates for the Department of Manufacturing and Mechanical Engineering and Technology is Department Chair, Professor Tim Passant.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Manufacturing Engineering Technology, Grant Lima.
Murphy Johnson.
Adam Niewert.
Zachary Noble.
Casey Rourke, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Mechanical Engineering Technology.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Mechanical Engineering, led by outstanding scholar Nicole Reyes, also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Manufacturing Engineering, summa cum laude, Tau Beta Pi, NAIA All-American, NAIA Scholar-Athlete.
Nicholas Armbrust, cum laude, Tau Beta Pi, Honors Program.
Trevor Carey.
Nicholas Cassaday, magna cum laude.
Marcus Della Martyr, cum laude.
Darian Devine. Alejandro Garcia Chagoya, cum laude. Trent Lamont, magna cum laude, Tau Beta Pi, Honors Program.
Cole Little.
Brendan Lloyd, cum laude.
Austin Morris.
Cade O'Neill, magna cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete, NAIA Academic All-American.
Ian Peters, summa cum laude, NAIA Scholar Athlete.
Corbin Remsburg.
Noah Renz, cum laude.
Roni Roundtree, magna cum laude, NAIA scholar athlete.
Eduardo Ruiz Lamas.
Corliss Russell, cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Lauren Sadrin, cum laude.
Dakota Salerno.
John Sarna.
Victoria Grace Steelman, Honors Program.
Luis Valadez, cum laude, Tau Beta Pi.
Hayden Vandehey, magna cum laude.
Aiden Williamson.
Kendon Wilson, cum laude.
The next degree is Bachelor of Science, Mechanical Engineering Technology, led by outstanding scholar Ian Martin, cum laude.
Jorge Manuel Andrade.
Sasha Robich.
Thank you, Dean FJ, Dr. House, and Professor Morgan for recognizing our graduates. There is one more step here, so I'm going to request all of our graduates to please rise. Graduates, please move your tassels to the left side of your cap, signifying your graduation from the Oregon Institute of Technology and Oregon Health and Science University School of Nursing. Please demonstrate our true spirit of joy with continued applause. Please be seated. And now for a special message from the President of the Alumni Advisory Board, Chris Frazier, a 2008 graduate of the Communication Studies Department. Chris Frazier earned an Associate of Arts from Oregon Tech in 2006 and Bachelor's in Communications with a minor in Psychology in 2008 before going to earn a Master's in Student Affairs and Higher Education from Colorado State University. While on campus, Chris served as a two-time ASOIT president, a K-Tech DJ, and was involved in several student clubs. After graduation, Chris worked on campus and student activities for 5 years before moving to Spokane, Washington, where she and her husband, Seth, who is also an Oregon Tech graduate, live with their daughter, Sydney, and son, Henry. When Chris graduated in 2008, she stood at this podium to deliver a student address to her fellow graduates and audience members in the stands. I am pleased today to welcome Chris back to the stage as an Oregon Tech supporter and an example to our graduates of how they can continue to support their alma mater after graduation. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Chris Frazier.
This is like deja vu. I feel like I was just here. As John Davis said earlier, this moment will imprint upon your minds, and I can tell you that because, like I said, I was just here, but I remember it so vividly. In fact, Aaron and I were just reminiscing about that moment. You guys feel that potential in this space? As I was watching all of you, I just felt this almost palpable potential. You guys are going places, and I'm so, so excited for you. I'm honored to speak to you, class of 2023, Oregon Tech's 75th graduating class. As I look back on my 15 years since graduating from Oregon Tech, I realize that some of the most meaningful and lasting connections I have to this day were made here at Oregon Tech. The 5 years I spent here on campus were some of the most formative years of my life, thanks in large part to many of the faculty and administrators who are still here with us today. Those years and experiences are the reason I chose to become involved as an alum and hopefully help others to have the same amazing experience as I did. While you may be leaving Oregon Tech, you are now a part of something new, something that ties you to this beloved Oregon Tech family for years to come. Just ask those guys in the yellow robes. The Oregon Tech Alumni Association. As part of a network of 30,000 alumni, you will have access to resources to help you find jobs, stay engaged on campus, find ways to give back to this fantastic institution. We want you to keep in touch and tell us about all of the amazing things you're up to. We invite you to give guest lectures, attend events, contribute to scholarship funds, and help recruit new students by telling them what an amazing experience you had here. Wherever you go from here, we hope you remember to thank those who helped you get here. Take a moment to express sincere gratitude for the many hours of study and sacrifice your professors gave to share their knowledge and teach you. For countless university staff and administrators who kept things going, often behind the scenes. Gratitude for your fellow students and friends who studied with you, encouraged you, and supported you. For your parents and family members who believed in you. For yourself, for accomplishing something I'm sure felt daunting or impossible at times. Display your diploma with pride and sport that Oregon Tech swag. Be proud of where you came from and the university you now represent. Share your love of Oregon Tech with anyone you meet. On behalf of the Alumni Association and the Alumni Advisory Board, I say congratulations and welcome to the alumni family. Go out and make us proud. Go Owls.
Okay. Thank you, Chris. Congratulations to all of our new alumni now. Graduates, you are now joining the ranks of thousands of Oregon Tech alumni. Now I ask all of you in the audience to help me do something very important to show all of our graduates how happy we are for their incredible accomplishments as Oregon Tech graduates. So listen to the instruction. Let's bring the house down with a final round of applause and recognition of our graduates. Not a polite applause, but a standing, stomping, yelling, enthusiastic round of applause. Let's do it. That was awesome. Thank you. Please be seated. As we close today's ceremony, all of us at Oregon Tech wish you well in the coming months and years. As our new alumni, we may call on you to support the next generations of students, just as those before you have, with class presentations, job tips, networking help, and support to help our students stay in school and excel. Please join us in honoring the graduates and visit with faculty, family, and friends for light refreshments at the fountain in the center of campus immediately following the ceremony. For departmental gatherings, please look for the department signs in that area. With the exception of the recessional, the events of the 75th Oregon Tech commencement are concluded. The faculty, staff, and administration of Oregon Institute of Technology congratulate the class of 2022-23. Please rise for the recessional, and please allow the graduates and faculty to exit prior to leaving the stadium. Thank you, safe travels, and have a great summer.
Yeah.